So, in the previous videos, I got a bunch of these crusher glasses from Electric. I made a silicone mold, then cut them out, took out the glasses, dissolved them, and then took out the hardware from the glasses and put them back in the mold along with some flowers and some resin, some UV resin. Let those harden, pull them out. Then I had to shave it down and shave it down and fix all the air holes and fix all more of the air holes and then shave it down and shape it and reshape it. Woo! It was a lot of work. And then shape it again and then again shave it down until I had some glasses and then shine them up. And that's what I did in the last video. In this one, after getting together, I needed to make another pair. So here we go. This video is sponsored by Squarespace. So these glasses, I took them apart, and when making the legs, I just made the little mold in the little bottle thing like I showed you in the last video, and I added the silicone, the liquid silicone stuff, put it in and let it dry. Then when it was dry, I cut it out and tore off the plastic thing to make these little mold for these glasses and had to cut them out. So I didn't show this, I don't think, in the last video, but what I did with these legs after I got them nice and cut out, which apparently was a pain. Look at me struggle there. Just get them out. But once I got them out, I actually took them and I dissolved them in these cute little flute glasses and added in some acetone to melt them down. And I had that third glass, so I thought I would just add in some bubbly to drink while I waited for it to dissolve. Also, while I'm waiting for it to dissolve, let me tell you a little story. So back in 2010, I entered this contest to make these board shorts for Volcom, and I won. Super, super, super stoked about it. And like part of the prize was they were going to fly me out to California to see the headquarters, and then they were going to make a pair of these shorts. And so while I was out in the headquarters, they let me see like their shop, and then they actually gave me like some credit to buy some stuff. And at the time, Volcom and Electric were owned by the same company, so that was the first time that I bought some Electric goggles. And I've loved Electric ever since. So those dissolved pretty good, but they needed to be dissolved more, so I emptied out all the old acetone and bloop, spilled all the new acetone all over. And then I needed to dissolve some frames for the second pair, and so I did that. Here's a cute little time lapse of it dissolving this time. Unlike the last video where I let it sit for too long and it turned into like a complete solid, it just dissolved to the right point to where I could pull out the metal hardware. So I pulled those out and put them in a separate little tin of acetone to get it all the way dissolved. Ooh, the texture was actually really cool. And then I took the metal out of the legs, and it was interesting. There was like a little snakeskin type coat that was over those. I feel like it's probably like UV protection or something. So then I just poured out all the extra acetone and got that second flute with the second pair of hardware. Made sure that they were gonna dissolve. I actually took apart a third pair of glasses because I wanted to fix this mold. So first thing, I had to get it back into the mold, which was actually super, super hard. I thought it was going to be easier than that. And then I wanted to fix this little spot there on the top. So with the little bit of extra silicone stuff that I had left, I just added a little layer and we're going to let that dry. And while that dries, I thought it'd be fun to like decorate the cases that they come in. And I really love white on white, like the subtlety of that. I'm giving up on that word. I wasn't like super stoked on how that looked, but I thought maybe if I took some of the UV resin and just used that to paint a little cute little flower, maybe that would work. So I did that, then let it sit out in the sun to see how it would cure. And it seemed like it was doing well. Did a little bend test and looks good. So then I just did the whole thing with the UV resin. I really like how it's like glossy, adds a cute little texture to the top there. So we'll just put that on the sun to dry. Meanwhile, these are the little arms that go inside the legs of the glasses. I thought it'd be cool to like add my little brand to the side, add a little bit to this collab. So I just took a little Sharpie and wrote my name and then did the same thing on the left side of the frames. So hopefully when you look through the resin and the flowers, you can see my little signature. At least that's the plan. So I just gotta shove those into the mold and add some of the flowers in. There we go. Add more flowers in. You're doing so good. There were so many issues that I ran into the first two episodes of this series. So glad that it's all working out. Learn to add the flowers first and then add in the resin, and that'll let them sit out into the sun. So while those were sitting, I thought I'd go back to the case. And I took this like water soluble pencil and drew out Shmoxd. And I wanted to do like some sort of chain stitch, but was struggling. So to pull it through, I had to use some pliers. And yeah, start with one stitch, did a couple pre-poking holes to hopefully help me pull that stitch through more. Added in the text more and did more pre-poked holes. And that way, right now, I could actually rinse off all that, the yellow, because it was water dissolving pencil. That way I didn't have to try to do that with the thread on there, because I feel like it would have turned the thread yellow. So I did some of the chain stitching and still had to use the pliers, but made it a little bit easier to see. And I ended up doing that all off camera. Thought it looked pretty cool. And to do it on this one, I found kind of a better way than using the yellow pencil. I figured if I just drew it out on paper and then just pushed the needle through, that should give me enough of an image to see what I need to do. And it worked. And poof, got a cute little chain stitch. So back to this guy. Remember how I put a layer on there to try to fix that center thing? Well, it just did not work. And I think it's because I was using like the leftovers of all of that. So I went to the store and got some new silicone mold stuff and added a fresh new layer on top. You have to like mix this one to one. It comes in two parts. And I think that's why it just didn't work that first time. So now that that has, my legs have sat out in the sun, we can take them out. And I already saw that there's some parts like not fully full. Sure. So I just filled them up and put them out in the sun some more. And there we go. We got two cute legs. Wow, those legs are so cute. This is now dry. So I took off the tape. And we just have to recut out these glasses. So I was cutting them. And as I was cutting them, I realized that they're on the right side. It like still wasn't all the way dry. I don't know what was going on. So I kind of just cut that part out that wasn't all the way dry. And pulling out the glasses. Good job. Oh, missed a spot. There we go. But it honestly just like peeled off in a second layer. So it still just like didn't stick to the old stuff. I figured I could just put some of the resin there and then add that layer back on top. And hopefully that would work to make that little thing go away. So I put that out in the sun to cure and we'll see. Gotta take out the glasses. So I checked around the sides to make sure there wasn't any big air holes, air pocket bubbles, and there was right there. And so I just added a little bit more. Good job. Then just added a lot more just to be safe, put it out in the sun, and then took off all that crunchy layer on top and started prying out those glasses. As I was prying it out, it got super bent and kind of misshapen. So I figured what I could do is just take some of the lenses and then plop them in for a second, let it sit for a second, then pull them out. And hopefully that will hold its shape.
All right, so huge thank you to today's sponsor, Squarespace. If you've seen one of my videos, you know that I love Squarespace. I've been using it forever. If you don't know what Squarespace is, it's kind of just your one-stop shop for all things website. So let's say you want to make a mold of these glasses and fill them up with resin and put some flowers in it and then sell them to the masses. Well, Squarespace can help make that possible. Or if you have like a digital product or really anything, a blog, whatever. One thing I really like about Squarespace is how user-friendly the e-commerce is. It takes me forever to make something, and so the last thing I want to do is have to spend hours on getting it online, making it look good and work and function so that I can sell it to people. And they've streamlined that process so that if I have an idea, I can have it up that night. Another great thing is they have templates. Not only is it gonna be up quick, it's gonna look professional, and it's customizable so that you can make it on brand to whatever you want it to be. Lastly, I really love their award-winning 24/7 customer support. So if you have a question, they got answers. You have an idea, they can help make that a reality. So while I've been talking, maybe you've thought of something that you could make on a website. You can actually go to the link in my description, squarespace.com/Shmoxd, and start making your website for free today. And then when you do decide to launch it or buy a domain or whatever, remember the coupon code Shmoxd to get 10% off your first purchase. So let's make that idea a reality with Squarespace.
So just like the last glasses in the last video, I had to shave them all down, fix all the air bubbles, all that stuff. And then I hit it with this UV light one more time, just to make sure it was nice and cured, and put in the frames. There we go. Got two cute glasses. One, I did the glossing where I put a layer of resin on it. And the other one I left matte by just sanding it off with like a pretty high grit so that it had that matte texture. With them all open up, you can see the like all the hardware that's inside of it, and those glossy ones being the first ones that I made, really stoked with how like the lettering, and then these matte ones, you can see like my little Shmoxd on the inside of the legs there. So really stoked with how these turned out. Put them on into their cases to get the full effect, and voila, two cute glasses, very cute. So I wanted to go outside and model them in the sun, but it was raining. That was me earlier that day. It was literally like rivers going down the road. So because it was raining so much and because I needed to get these to electric, I thought I'd jump on a plane. So that's me in Salt Lake, and I headed over to LA. Cool. Went to the electric headquarters and dropped these glasses off to my guy Ian, who I've been chit-chatting with the whole time, and used their giant mirror. Oh, cute dog. Use that giant mirror to take a look at them. Honestly, super stoked with how these turned out. We're going to be doing a giveaway for these, Electric and I. They're keeping one of the pairs, and the other pair we're going to be giving away to you. And that giveaway will actually be happening in the next couple months before the holidays. So if you guys want to be up to date on that, you can join my email list. You can join Electric's email list. You can follow us on Instagram, and we'll keep you posted on how to win one of these glasses. Also, if you want, you can get 20% off any of their glasses, which they were telling me that's like not a discount code that they give out easily. So if you want, you can head to their website. I'll put the link in the description. And use the coupon code Shmoxd20 to get 20% off one of the pair of these glasses here. All right, so be sure to like and subscribe. Go ahead and hit that bell notification. And yeah, if you want to be a Shmoxdy Pie and get your name on my video here at the end, just go to my website.